the truck stop, everybody. Hopefully you guys are having a fantastic freaking day. So we're on a road that I have not showed yet. this is pretty much the last one. anyways, hey, we're going to get this out of the way. If you guys enjoy the video or you want to show your support like you guys normally do, go ahead and hit that thumbs up, all right? It's story time with the old friendly neighborhood truck driver, me. so, the spider one, I cannot believe I actually told you this, but you know what? I did. I done did it. I got one more. I've got a ton more, but this one, I cannot believe I did this. I cannot believe I did not end up in jail. It was bad. And I hate this intersection right there. I hate it. There was a really bad accident involving a semi and a car. It didn't turn out good for either one. It was a mess. And every time I come through this intersection, I remember exactly where everything was. And the smell that I smelled when I came through there, it was, I hate that intersection. I absolutely hate it. I've been driving for a long time. I started driving in 1996. It was actually June of 1996. And I hooked up with a guy named Ollie Fredericks out of Gibbon, Minnesota, where I grew up. Woo-hoo! GFW, baby, all the way! Whatever. and I was doing grain. You know, did that for a full season, did a load of beets, or a season of beets. And after that first year, I decided I wanted to go over the road. And so I did. Hooked up with a company that's no longer in business, but got hired on with the company, and you know, went to Jersey a couple times, you know, and it was my first year over the road. So I was coming up from Texas, I believe it was, but anyways, it was Kearney, Missouri. And now, if you guys know that scale house on Kearney, at Kearney, Missouri, or Missouri, there used to be, umpteen years ago, there used to be an older, chubbier guy that was the scale house guy there. A complete asshole. I mean, he hated life itself. He was just a jerk to everything and everybody. I think he went home and kicked his dog just cuz. I don't think he actually did that. Well, he might have done that. That's how grumpy this guy was. And now, I've been across a few scales by this time. I still was unsure because every scale that I was going across was completely brand new. And every scale has its own little quirk to it. You know, you enter this way, you exit this way, you go around this way, you follow this light. They all have their little quirks to them, right? So, seeing the scale was open, so I pulled in. You know, I was 100% legal, the load was light, and I was heading back up to Minnesota. So, I pull in, you know, I follow all the lights, I get on the scale, and I had my window down because at that time, there was no lights or anything like that. It was red and green, and they yelled at you through a PA system. So I had my window down, and the guy gets on the scale, on the PA and goes, "Driver, pull around back and bring all your paperwork and books in." I instantly thought, why does he want to see all my log books? I'm like, this doesn't make any sense. I mean, I can understand the paperwork, but why does he want to see all my log? I'm like, okay, well, you know, he asked for all my books. So I pull around back and I park and I grabbed everything and I walked in. The guy in front of me just got his ass chewing. And I walked up to the counter, you know, and it was in the morning, and I said, "Good morning, sir." And I was kind of pooping bricks at that time, because this was literally the first time I was ever this is the first time in a while, I should say, because there was one other time before this that I actually was in a scale house, but that was a completely different time and a completely different story. And I will tell you guys about that story because it's kind of cool. But so I pull in, I'm shitting bricks, you know, because I just heard this guy in front of me get his butt reamed. And so I put myself up on the counter and I said, "Good morning, sir." And I'm shivering on the inside because I'm scared. The guy looks at me, he looks at the counter, he looks at me, he does that like 3 or 4 different times. And he looks at me and he goes, "How many logbooks are you running?" And I went, "Oh, I'm only running the one. 2 are old and 5 are from our new ones." And he looked at me and let me tell you, if he could have killed me just from looking at me, I would have been dead so many times. He's like, "What kind of smart ass are you?" And I'm like, "Sir, you said bring all your books in." I said, I'm new. I don't understand what you mean by when you say this. And so he, man, did he get pissed. He didn't even look at anything else. So I'm standing there. The guy behind me is just absolutely bored that I did this, because the scale house guy and this other driver thought I was doing this on purpose. And I really wasn't. No joke, I was new to the over-the-road stuff. And so he got so pissed. And he shoved everything at me. Some of it went on the floor, some of it stayed on the counter. And "Get the hell out of my scale, and if I ever see you going up and down this road again, I will write you up and throw you in jail." I mean, that's what he told me. And so I was like, "Oh, whoa, okay." So I picked everything up off the floor and I made a beeline to the truck. At that time, because it wasn't a weight ticket, at that time, and I believe most of the scales now have a bypass lane. So I just went around the scale and I got the hell out of there. It was 2 weeks later, I had to go back through there again. And guess what happened? Puts me up on the scale and he goes, "Driver, pull around back and bring in your paperwork and bring in your log book." Yes, sir. I pull around back, I bring in my paperwork. I'm legal. I was close to 80,000, but I was legal. And I walk inside and he goes, "Boy, I thought I told you if you ever come through here again." And I'm like, "Sir, I don't know what you're talking about." You know, I tried playing it off and stuff like that. And he's like, "Yeah, you're the smart ass that brought in your 9 freaking logbooks and blah, 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 blah." And he goes, "I bet you think you're funny, don't you?" I'm like, no, well, yeah. On the inside, I'm laughing, but because I knew this time, you know, there was absolutely nothing you could do. But he, "Get the hell off my scale." He shoved my stuff back in. This time I caught it, which apparently pissed him off. Because from what I've gathered from friends and people that I've talked to, the guy likes to do that. He'll look at your stuff and then just throw it back at you. And the guy's long gone now. I think he's passed away, or I know he's retired for sure. But I think he's actually passed away. And so I left. It was a year later in my own truck. It was a little over a year. In my own truck, I had to go back through there. Guess who I saw? I'm like, I sat there and I was like, "Oh my God, please don't remember. Please don't remember me. Please don't remember me." Yeah, guess who remembered me? Started throwing exact dates out too. Anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed my little oops at the scale. If you guys are new around here, go ahead and hit that thumbs up. Or subscribe button. It'll hit the thumbs up too. But hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and grab your front row parking. Because every row here at the truck stop is front row, baby. I got you covered. Got you covered. Don't have to walk so far. All right, I gotta make a turn that way. I'll talk to you guys next week. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.